Today we will discuss oscilloscope. We will discuss power supply, earth connection and isolation transformer. Time plot, XY plot, coupling, AC, DC ground, vertical position control, vertical scale control, horizontal time scale control, triggering, wave shape comparison and XY plot. Two type of oscilloscope are used mostly. One is DSO, one is CRO. DSO means Digital Storage Oscilloscope. CRO means Cathode Ray Oscilloscope. Basic function in both DSO and CRO are same. This scope is DSO. Now I will tell first about earthing. This is power point, this is CRO, and two props are connected, prop 1 and prop 2 with channel 1 and channel 2. This both prop have one common point shown here in green color. This common point is shorted inside CRO like this. This means voltage of this point should be same. It should not be different. If this is different, then shorting will be there like this. Then second is, suppose here we are measuring 230 volt or 110 volt AC, then common point, earth point of this incomer signal and this power supply should be same. It should not be different. Now this is another way of using CRO. In this we connect an isolating transformer between incomer and CRO. This is 1:1 transformer. In this case, this grounding of AC input signal and this power supply can be different. I have shown same. It can be common, it can be different. This is a much safer way of using CRO. Please connect a transformer between CRO and power. Then this point, it can be kept floating. And this common can be connected to signal common wherever required. I have shown here, but this point is actually earthing of incomer signal. Now I have one prop. This is 10:1. This prop can be connected to one channel of scope like this. But if you don't have 10:1 prop, you may have BNC to banana connector, then this point will go here. And it will have two connections, one red color, one black color. Black color will go to common and red color will go to signal. If you have two prop, another prop can be connected here. Earlier I have told in CRO or DSO, this is DSO, there will be two channel. But in some CRO there will be only one channel. In this scope there are two channel, channel 1 and channel 2. These two are input. Here we have to give voltage input. It will not take current input. If you want to measure current, you have to convert current into voltage using some prop or some other method and then give voltage here. Now CRO display or function can be used in two ways. This is one way, this is another way. In this way, this x-axis is considered time and y-axis two voltage, V1 and V2. V1 here, V2 here. So you will get two wave shape, one for V1, say this red color, another for V2, say black color, or it may be same color. So this voltage signals are time dependent signal. This is time dependent plot. In this case, we don't use time function. This is called the XY plot. For this XPRI plot, we are not required to make any changes in connections. We have some setting here. Some CRO may have, some CRO may not have. Using that setting, we can use screen as a XY. In that case, one voltage may be X in my CRO. Channel 1 is X. See, X is written here. This is Y written here. So channel 2 is Y in XY plot case. So this will be V1, this will be V2, and you will get plot V2 versus V1. It can be circle, it can be straight line or some other. Now we will discuss coupling. Coupling, suppose this is input signal. This input signal is this. And this is circuit inside of CRO. So there are three ways to connect this input to circuit. To select these three ways, there will be switch. In my case, this switch here and here. In some CRO, switch may be here. Depending on CRO, switch location may change. There are three type of connections: DC, AC and ground. If you connect to ground, you select the ground, then circuit is connected directly to ground. This input will not go here. If AC is selected, then between input and circuit one high pass filter will come. I have shown here RC. This is inside CRO. This side is inside CRO. I have shown RC, but actual inside it may be active filters. So only AC will go. In third case, if you select DC, signal will go directly. AC and DC, all will go. And this selection is different for both channel. In my case, selection is here. In some CRO, selection may be here, here or here. Depending on CRO, method of selection will be different. But concept is same. Now I will see these three in this yellow. Channel 2 is yellow signal. At present, I have selected DC. This is zero line. So it is having DC plus AC both. Now I have selected DC. I will select AC. See, this yellow line has come down. This is zero line. So there is no DC now. Only AC signal you are seeing. Now I will show ground. I will select ground. Ground. Now input is connected here. Zero line. In this case, input is connected through this filter. High pass filter. So only AC is coming. And if I connect DC coupling, then DC plus AC both are coming. Suppose you have a small AC signal and more DC, then you will not be able to see AC signal. That time we use AC. Now we come to vertical position shift control. These are two knobs separate for both channel. Using this, we can shift the wave shape. These two wave shapes are two inputs. I am generating these two wave shapes using one simple 555 circuit. Now when we move this knob, whole wave shape will shift up and down. This is vertical position control. Similarly, for channel 2, there is another button. We can move like this. Advantage of this vertical position shift is ki both we can bring together both wave shape and compare them. Now we will discuss vertical scale voltage per division. Vertical scale means y axis. Volt per division scaling in y axis. So there are two knobs here. For both channel, this control, vertical scale control, will be different. You can select separately. One may be 10 volt per division, another may be 5 volt per division. Now what is division? This is one division. You are seeing one bigger line here, one bigger line here. About 1 centimeter in my scope. Other scope, this may be different. So this is one division. From here to here, this is one division. Now suppose we say 10 volt per division. Means what? Between this and this point, 10 volt will come. Scale will be 10 volt for this distance. Now, suppose I have one signal here, and this is 10 volt, and I have set 10 volt per division. So within one division, signal will come. Now if we change from 10 volt to 5 volt, so one division from here to here is 5 volt. To make 10 volt, it will require two division. So this signal will become like this. Here I will show. This red color. If I change the scale, it will height will increase. Signal is same. It is visible bigger, further increased. If it goes more, it may go out of range. Similarly, yellow one, second channel. Both separate we can select. This is one, this is another. See, yellow, second channel. I am controlling Y scale, volt per division. This is more volt per division. This is less volt per division. Less volt per division means it will look bigger. Wave shape look bigger. Now suppose one signal is like this. This yellow one I am showing here. This is DC value and AC value both. And this is zero line. And scale is 2 volt per division. Now if we make 1 volt per division, everything will go up. DC also will be like this, and AC also will be like this. This point will go little higher, this point will go little higher. I will show. See, both got shifted. Earlier this was here, this was here, like this. When I reduce the scale, both will get shift. If you go further, it will go out of range. If you want only this AC, then you have to select the AC scale. Coupling. This is coupling. I select AC coupling. Now DC has gone, only AC. Now if you make like this, the DC problem will not be there. This AC alone you can extend the scale. Horizontal or time scale control. In my scope, this is horizontal time scale control. This is always common for two channels in normal CRO. So I have two channels in my scope, this is common. Now suppose there is a wave shape, then this will show voltage, this will show time, and there is a square wave. And we have set value 1 millisecond per division. 1 millisecond per division means what? 1 division means from here to here. So, from this point to this point is 1 millisecond. So this width is little less than 1 division. Division are visible here also. So this width is less than 1 millisecond. This width is more than 1 division. So this width is more than 1 millisecond if we set 1 millisecond per division. Now suppose this is the wave shape. So here voltage is coming down after 1 millisecond. Then again going up after 1 millisecond. Now suppose we change the scale from 1 millisecond to 0.5 millisecond. then one division will be 0.5 millisecond. So to cover 1 millisecond full, two divisions are required. So this voltage is still coming down at 1 millisecond, but it is taking longer width because I have changed the scale. So this wave shape will look like this, and everything will get shifted. Here I will show. See, both are changed, it is shifted. Now earlier this was something like this, and here it was 1 millisecond per division. Now I have made 0.5 millisecond per division, that is 500 microsecond per division. In your scope, this division may be here. In my case, it is written here. So this wave shape has become something like this. Both are changing horizontal wise. I can change further. We can go on changing. Now suppose you want to measure this rise time and fall time, then you have to expand like this. Go on expanding, then rise and fall time will come. Will keep like this, and then we'll measure what is the time difference between this point to this point. Now, this is the wave shape. Using horizontal position control, we can shift this wave shape anywhere. This is used generally to bring this rise or fall time in this line, such that we can measure greatly. This is not triggering control, it is only horizontal position control. Now we will understand what is triggering. Suppose this is a wave shape. And this is starting point in screen. Triggering means where we want to start. Here, here, here. Suppose there are 3 points, 1, 2, 3. If we set triggering point at 1, then wave shape will start like this from 1. This line will be like this. At present it is like 1. If you want triggering at 2, wave shape will be like this. If you want triggering at 3, wave shape will start like this. This is triggering control. Now we will change and see. See, this dotted line is the triggering label. We will adjust this voltage. Suppose triggering voltage we adjust like this. It will trigger at 1. If we make triggering voltage this, it will trigger at 2 or 3. So now it is at 1. Now we will shift. See, shifting. It has become like 2. This portion before 2 is not visible. Then we will make like 3. See. Now it has become like this. Starting point. This is 3. We are changing using this trigger control. This is like 2, and again we will shift. This is like 1. Now this triggering voltage should be within range. If we go out of range, see the dotted line go behind for this. See, it becomes unstable. It becomes like this. What happens if we cannot trigger? Sometime wave will start at 1, sometime 2, sometime 3, so it will be like this. See, so triggering label has to be within range. Now we have selected, you can select, you want to trigger channel 2 or channel 1. I have selected channel 2. Now we will trigger channel 1. What happens? In every scope we can select. In some scope, it is some switch here. In my case, it is digital. Now I will change channel source channel 2 to channel 1. Now you see this red line. This is trigger level. This is out of range, so it is not stable. Now I will bring within range. See, it has become stable. Because we are triggering channel 1 now. We have selected, this is called source of triggering. Source of triggering can be channel 1 or channel 2. Earlier, when I was showing here, source of triggering was channel 2. Now source of triggering is channel 1. See. Now if triggering level goes out of range, it will become unstable. So it has to be within range. So you can select the channel, you can select the label. Then this is internal triggering using channel 1 or channel 2. Then there will be some function you can trigger using line frequency. Line frequency will be helpful if your circuit is synchronized with line frequency. Then you can get stable wave shape. Then this is external triggering. So far we were using either channel 1 voltage or channel 2 voltage or reference for triggering. External triggering means this is another input. We give some signal here and trigger that. In that case, that signal will be in synchronization with these two. Otherwise, it will not be stable. Sometimes what happens, here lot of disturbance will be there. Lot of noise will be there. Then it will be difficult to trigger. That time we use external triggering. Or in many other complex applications, we use external triggering. Now you can trigger here, you can trigger here, you can trigger here also. Depending upon scope, it will have many functions, many method, many point of triggering to bring wave shape in stable condition. Now we will learn how to compare two wave shape. For comparing two wave shape, one is red color channel 1, one is yellow color channel 2. First we overlap these two. Now I have overlap. This may be different, maybe like this, maybe like this. So we bring together using this vertical position control. There are two vertical position controls, one for channel 1, one for channel 2. So we bring both in middle, like this. Now two comparison are possible, one in time mode, one in Y scale, or logic comparison. Now here we are seeing, when this signal goes high, charging will start. In my case, this indicates charging, this indicates discharging. So as soon as one signal goes low to high, immediately charging will start. When the signal goes from high to low, immediately discharging will start. So this is charging, this is discharging, and this always happens whenever this signal, channel 1 signal, is changing. This is time comparison. If you want more close comparison, you can expand further. You can change time scale and see more accurate. You are seeing little fluctuation. It may be because of noise. Now vertically we will see. Let us measure the voltage of this yellow channel 2. So this one is zero line. This is zero line. So we can measure the voltage of this point and this point. We will know when this channel, this signal goes from 0 to high, that time what was the voltage of this channel 2. So we will measure the voltage at this point. Scale is 1 volt per division. In my case, it is written here. In some CRO, scale may be here. Different scale will be there, for both channels. So one volt per division means this is 1 volt, there are 5 columns, so one column is 0.2 volt. So from here, 1 volt, 2 volt, 2.2, 2.4, 2.6, 2. Roughly 2.8 volt. We can bring at this point of measurement using this horizontal position here in middle line. So it will be easier to measure. 1 volt, 2 volt. Now you can count easily. 2.2, 2.4, 2.6, 2.8. Like that. Now voltage of this point, we can bring this point. I am shifting just to make easier to measure. You can keep anywhere. This is horizontal position control. Now voltage of this point, yellow one. This is zero line. It is 1 volt per division. So 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volt, 4 volt, 5 volt, 5.2, 5.4, 5.6, 5.8. Like that we can measure. Now we will discuss XY plot. In XY plot, X will not be time. It will be voltage of one channel. In our case, this is X, this is Y. So X is channel 1. So this is the voltage of channel 1. This is the voltage of channel 2. So far I have not set CRO for XY mode. This is in time mode only. This is red color. Each channel 1, that is X, and yellow color, each channel 2, Y. So this is channel 2, yellow color, this is red color, channel 1. Now this red color voltage is going from 1 volt to 8 volt, then comes down. In yellow color case, this is going approximately from 2 volt to 6 volt and comes down. So this vary between 1 and 8 fixed. This vary 2 to 6 and then 6 to 2. Now I will make XY mode. In my case switch is here, but in some scope switch may be here. So I select XY mode. Now these two lines are like this. Now this is time. Two wave shape has become like this in XY mode. How? I will explain why two lines are coming like this. This wave shape I divided in 6 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points. In X scale this is 1 volt, this is 8 volt. In Y this is 2 volt, this is 6 volt. At point 1, X is 8 volt, Y is 2 volt. So point 1 is X is 8 volt, Y is 2 volt, so 8-2. Similarly at point 2, X is 8 and Y is somewhere here between 2 and 6, maybe 4. So 8 volt and 4 volt, so 8 and 4. This is 8, this is 4. At point 3, X remains 8, but Y we have become 6. So at point 3, 8-6. X is 8 volt. Y is 6 volt. This is 6. So point 1, 2, 3, voltage of X remains same 8 volt. This is 6, 8 volt X. But Y is changing from 2 volt to 6. 2, 4, 6. 2, 4, 6. 2 volt, 4. This is point 1, 2, 3, but voltage is 2 here, 4 here, 6 here. Similarly here, in 4, 5, 6 point, X is always 1 volt. So point here, 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 value of X is always 1 volt. I have written 1, 1, 1. But value of Y at point 4, 6 volt. At point 4, it is 6 volt. Point 5 is this. Point 5 is this. And point 6 is this. So 4, 5, 6 points, X is same 1 volt, but Y is coming down from 6 to 2. So here, in this line, 0.4 to 6, x is same 1 volt, but value of y is coming down from 6 volt to 2 volt. So line is like this. So this and this together is this, and this and this together is this. Now what we will do, we will reverse this channel. Here, x was constant, only 2, either 1 volt or 8 volt. Y was changing. We'll make reverse, then y will be constant and x will reverse. See what happens. See, line become like this. Now in this case, y is constant, only either this or this, because I have connected this signal to y. And x is changing, because I have connected this signal to x. Today this much only.